Welcome to the Grok Shop. If you look at your task manager in Windows 10, you might find some apps running that you didn't start up yourself. For example, here I'm showing the yourphone.exe app, which I've never used and definitely did not start myself. So what's going on, right? In Windows 10, Microsoft introduced universal Windows platform apps. These apps have a special ability to run in the background. They can also be suspended, but even when they're suspended, they can still be doing things, as shown here in Microsoft's own article. So in the interest of security and conserving resources, I highly recommend disabling all background apps that you don't need. Quite a few of these apps ship with Windows already enabled. Today I'm going to show how you can disable these. By disabling these apps, it makes it so the apps can't run unless we start the apps ourselves. So in order to play along, you need to have Windows 10 build 10.1.34 as a minimum. To check your build, just do a WinS and type system, go to system information, and there at the top at the end of the version string, you'll find your build number. So let's get started by going to start. Next, click the little gear for settings. Next, we're going to click in the area with the lock icon that says privacy. Okay, now in the left column, we'll scroll down to find background apps and click that. So yeah, in this area, you have the ability to control individual apps. If you happen to have some apps that you want to be able to do stuff in the background, you'll have to turn every other app off except the ones that you want. In my case, I don't want any of these apps to be able to run in the background. So I'm going to use the slider at the top, which disables them all. And again, what these sliders do, it disables the ability of these apps to be able to do stuff in the background. So by turning them off, the apps still exist and you can still use them. They just can't do stuff in the background. But if, for example, you use the alarm clock and you turn everything off, your alarm clock might stop working. So be sure you go through and make sure there's nothing that you actually need. Okay, when you're all done there, you might find some apps are still running in the background. If you do, go ahead and do a reboot now. Once you're back up, you should find most of those backgrounded apps are gone. However, Microsoft still has a few that are super sticky, and I'll be covering these in a future video as far as how to get rid of those too. Now, if you're running an edition of Windows other than the Home Edition, you can also achieve the same result using the Group Policy Editor. We'll start by doing a WinR to open up the Run dialog and typing gpedit.msc. Okay, next we're going to open Administrative Templates, and then Windows Components. And finally, app privacy. Okay, the setting we want to adjust is called Let Windows Apps Run in the Background. So we'll double click that. Okay, next we want to change the radio button from Not Configured to Enable. Okay, here you can set a default for all apps. I'm setting mine to Force Deny for everything. You can set it to Force Allow, or you can set up Blacklist and Whitelist in these fields below here, or you can cede control to the user for certain apps. You just need to figure out what the app names are for the apps you want to do that for and put those in the fields here. Once you're all done there, we want to go ahead and reboot now. Okay, when you come back up, everything should look more better. Everything should be cleaner. You shouldn't have as many background apps running. You might still find some background apps running. As I mentioned earlier, there's a few that have been anointed by Microsoft and they're particularly sticky. I'll be addressing those in future videos though. For some additional tips and techniques on dealing with these background apps, be sure to check out my associated blog post. So that's it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, thumbs me up or give me a comment. Be sure to stay tuned for more Windows 10 optimization and privacy clampdown videos. But as far as giving Windows 10 background apps the boot goes, that's how it's done. Thanks for watching.